After the raising of Lazarus from the dead, many people saw what had happened and began to believe in Jesus. A decision was taken by the synagogue of the Jews to kill both Christ and Lazarus. Jesus therefore flees, giving place to evil, while the Jews were planning to kill him during the feast of Passover. When a considerable time had been given to flight, Jesus came 6 days before Passover to Bethany, as Scripture says, where Lazarus was, the one who had been dead. And there a meal took place, in which Lazarus also ate with him, but his sister Mary poured sweet perfume over his feet. And the next day he sent his disciples to bring the ass and her colt. And he who has heaven as his throne entered Jerusalem, mounted on the colt. The children of the Hebrews threw their garments over it, and cutting down branches of palm trees, and carrying others in their hands, went ahead of him crying out, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, the King of Israel." This happened because the all-holy Spirit moved their tongues to praise and extol Christ. They showed this through the palms, that is, the branches, which signified in advance the victory of Christ over death. For it was the custom for victors in contests or wars to be honored and escorted in victory processions with branches of evergreen trees. The colt, on the other hand, signified us, the people from the nations, on which Christ, seated and rested upon it as victor and conqueror, was proclaimed as King of the whole earth. Of this feast, the prophet Zechariah said, "Rejoice greatly, daughter of Zion. See, your king comes to you, meek and seated on a beast of burden and a colt of an ass, the offspring of a beast of burden." And David again says of the children, "From the mouth of babes and sucklings you have made sure of praise." But as Christ entered, Scripture says, "All Jerusalem was shaken, and the crowds, provoked to the vengeance by the chief priests, were looking to make away with him." The one who spread the sky out with the word, seated upon a colt, now seeks to free from dumb unreason all the human beings.